please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Welcome to what is the seventh edition of Tie the Knot.
We've had tremendous successes like Wishberry, Curify, Mistag, Wedmigood, Edu4Share, and very recently LinkSmart and Peabody. And we're going to add 5 to that list today.
So folks, ready to raise 13 crores over the next 1 hour. Ready? Okay. Our first company is Canwin.
I'm Kavita Gupta.
Hi, I'm Arun Gupta.
We are from Canwin, an R&D-based organization working in innovative oncology products for cancer patients and survivors.
We are looking for a funding of 2 crores with an equity dilution of 10%.
I will just like to share a short story. Arun is a cancer fighter. And he was diagnosed with cancer in 2011. And we founded an NGO to work for the cancer patients in the same year. When I was working in the NGO, I came up with this problem of breast cancer patients that they were prescribed to wear a prosthetic bra, but they were not able to. But why? Because of the high cost of the imported silicone breast prosthesis, which was available in the market. And the low-cost version, it couldn't meet the medical requirements which a patient has to. So I decided to do something and I invented this low-cost breast prosthesis. It is all made of the hypoallergenic material. All the material used in it is the heat-resistant material. So I got it patented and patent application has been filed. I got it approved from AIIMS, Rajiv Gandhi and 18 oncologists pan-India.
The product carries a huge price arbitrage against the wholesale price of 6,500 rupees per piece, which is the minimum price that silicon-based processes commands. We are offering it at 1,200 rupees to the distributor. We have got interest from two international companies, one a US-based company, one a Dubai-based company, who are interested in marketing of our products across India, SAARC, and Mideast. Next 5 years, we are looking at a top line of 70 crores with 20% EBITDA.
So, how much money you have invested in the company till now?
Sir, as of now, it has been a meager investment, very initial phase.
How much?
Around 5 lakhs.
Between both of you, you have invested 5 lakhs?
Yes.
And you claim 20 crore of valuation?
Yes.
And what's the reason? What's the rationale behind 20 crore?
Sir, we are looking at the most conservative projections are 70 crores of top line with 20% EBITDA. The project is cash positive from the day one.
Coming back to what Sanjay mentioned, you've calculated total market potential at 60 crores.
Yes. Right?
And you're saying you will make 12 crores in profit.
Yes.
5 years from now.
No. 5 years from now, these workings, the projections that I showed you, that is only for Indian market, sir. We have not yet calculated the impact of our venturing out of India. See, I have got a unique product, which has a patent application.
Yeah, your patent is not granted, it's filed.
Patents are indefensible. I mean, you can't work on patents.
We can't work on the patents, right?
So forget about that.
So, I'm just saying, so in terms of what is so rare about what you're doing?
Sir, rare is my design, the components I'm using. It is markable on all the 3 parameters that a breast prosthesis should have.
You are a chartered accountant. How can a proprietor company where we can invest into it? Idea is you are not even investment ready in terms of getting yourself right cap table done. There is no structure to your company right now.
Whoa.
Sir, as of now, I have deliberately kept the structure open. It shall be guided by the investors' pattern.
Okay, I think your valuation is very, very high. I would expect that you start at half the level we are and then we negotiate.
Lower than half, because if the audience here thinks that by spending 5 lakh rupees, they can get a 10 crore valuation, it'll be setting a very bad example for every this.
Do guys want to look at a different valuation or do you want to give it a pass?
No, sir. Sir, I am very confident of my numbers. I have done a very detailed survey. We have done a very detailed pilot run since last 1 year. And being a chartered accountant, these are very conservative. We have We have a very detailed.
I'm ashamed to admit I'm also a chartered accountant, but that has nothing to do with valuation. Okay, so there is no leeway, investors.
If your valuation is not at least less than half, I don't think anybody will even want to meet you.
One of my favorite movies is Scarface, you know, and the line is never get high on your own supply.
Typically, at least you should be open for discussions. You never know, you know, what advice you might get from the investors, and sometimes it's very helpful.
We are in a pilot stage. We will grow it up. We will invest into it. We will grow it up and we will come back on it.
Hi, I am Sonam Motwani. I'm the founder of Rolling Cube. It's a manufacturing aggregator and consultancy platform. We help businesses take their product ideas from concept stage to mass manufacturing. I'm here to raise 4.5 crore for 15% equity.
I am an aerospace engineer from IIT Bombay. I had my first encounter with real-world manufacturing while I was building electric race car for Formula Student. And that's when I realized that manufacturing is tough, incredibly tough. Now, hardware startups can dream all they want to change the world through incredible products, but they won't be able to do so unless they have a level playing field through the same ecosystem which big companies are using for manufacturing. What we are bringing to the table is a web application which helps you manufacture your products from anywhere in the world in any quantity. How we do that? We provide a customer-focused and computer-coordinated supply chain. We have launched the concept of pooled manufacturing, where we help reduce costs by sharing the resources, and we provide algorithmic pricing for different stages, starting from prototyping till mass manufacturing.
4.5 crores for 15% equity.
What's your business model? How do you charge me money? Just answer.
What is your
question.
Revenue model?
What's your revenue model?
So on the manufacturing cost, we are margins, depending on the volume that you're producing with us. If it's at a prototype stage, we would charge a markup of 20%.
So there is no standardization?
There is standardization. So if it's a prototyping stage, it's 20% markup. At low volume manufacturing, it's 10%. And if you are in mass production, it's 5%.
Any precedence in other markets?
Yeah. So we have competitors globally who are following the same model across different manufacturing methods. They started in 2007 and have already raised $75 million.
So who's responsible for getting it done right?
It's Rolling Cube that is responsible.
You take it. So if something is not delivered or not unto the design, how do you handle that?
We have conditions with our users where we look at how we can work together to still make them deliver their product to the market.
You said about 300 odd orders executed different. How many of them were repeat orders?
We have around 10% of customers who have had repeat orders with us.
What is the current net revenue and what do you see it going up to?
So currently, we have committed contracts worth 35 lakhs. And in terms of revenue, we are planning to touch 14 crores by the end of 2019.
So now is whether we are going to pay 4.5 crores for 15% equity in Rolling Cube.
I don't understand the logic for coming with that valuation, to be honest with you.
Valuation is a problem or logic of the business?
Both.
Valuation is an issue. Current revenue does not support the valuation asked for right now. But yes, if you relook at it, happy to talk.
At a different valuation, you would be interested. Sir?
You've not proven your scalability model yet. I mean, I think you have a good idea. The platform looks nice. But you need to prove that. Then you can get the valuation jump you're looking at.
1 crore, 15%. 1 crore, 15%.
1 crore, 15% as against 4.5 crores. Yep.
Which says that even the amount being raised is probably too high. So you need to probably look at your cash flow.
I will tag with Sanjay. Same comment.
After 1 crore valuation, everybody.
Because they may require 1 crore to justify the business, make the business case.
Okay, sir.
I want to see a demo. I want to talk to 2 customers before I can comment what I want to do.
We'll be happy to look at product capabilities. And if that is there, definitely interested.
I am interested in taking it across the table on a one-to-one basis.
Yeah, 1 crore, 9 people putting in, she'll have to give 135% of the company.
Right. If you get to that valuation, even I'll invest.
I would say 1 crore is pretty low, and we can do a lot better because we are not creating a single product or products in a single category. We are creating an entire ecosystem.
I think the first thing that interested me was the entrepreneur. She looks very capable. I really found her smart. And the space she's looking at is very interesting. I think people talk about manufacturing in India not growing as much, and that's where jobs will be in the future. So I think she fills a really big hole in the ecosystem. But I also think, I mean, what is holding me back is she's not built the scalable piece out yet.
I think for what she has done, 35 lakhs of revenue for the and the kind of money that she wanted to raise, I think it just didn't make sense. Fortunately for us and unfortunately for the entrepreneur, we live in a buyer's market, you know, and we get to see 300, 400 proposals a month. So valuation is not something which is made in Excel sheets. It's my need, greed to deploy capital in your opportunity versus your need to take capital for me. So it's more an art than a science.
Hi, I'm Saurabh.
Hi, I'm Mayank. We are co-founder of University Living.
So University Living is an international student housing marketplace wherein we help international students find their accommodation.
And we are seeking 3.5 crores with 18% dilution.
So right now, we are covering 3 continents. We are operating out of UK, Australia, Singapore, Dubai, and few popular cities in Europe. And we are covering 750 plus universities in these 50 cities. So talking about where we are adding value. So we are not a listing website, right? Everything is curated on a portal. Each and every property is being accredited by universities or been managed by biggest of accommodation providers across the world. So student can discover, compare, review, and book the accommodation from our portal itself. So we are addressing 10 million international students. This market is pegged at $5 billion. Talking about business model, don't charge students, but we've been paid by the commission by our accommodation providers. Our core competency is accommodation, but we aim to be a one-stop shop for post-admission services.
So University Living accommodation, 3.5 crores for 18%. Go ahead.
It's a very seasonal market, one, and there can be competition from every country with our inbound students. How do you check that?
Right. Thank you. So, you know, if you see, we have a global competitor, which is student.com, but they are we are based out of China. But there's always a cultural difference. There's always a language barrier. There's always a trust level because we are dealing with students. We're dealing with their parents.
You are just a lead generating website. I mean, there's no tech involved. Backend also, you are talking. I mean, this is just a business with a website. Ooh, right. And the valuations, the way you are asking, it's purely abnormal.
You know, we are working on automation wherein, you know, another pilot which we have done. You know, we are working on matchmaking. You know, there are so many students who want to stay together or in central London, but they don't have, you know, they don't want to spend 300, 350 pounds, right? So that's where we connected them and we are building a community for international students.
For the 3.5 crores, what are you spending their money on?
Right. So 40% will go into expansion of business, or I would say adding new geographies, because as I'm saying, everything is curated. Then 25% will go into team building.
Well, I'm interested, depending on the valuation, and of course I want to know the exit strategy because we haven't talked about that.
Frankly speaking, I don't think you are a tech business at all.
I'm interested in investing, subject to valuation, is someone else leading the deal?
I decline, I am not interested at all.
Not interested at all.
I'm prepared to have a conversation, understand your business a little more deep, to see how you can do a TripAdvisor type of a, you know, tech structure around your business.
Not interested.
So interested, but I think you know, of course, valuation has to be discussed.
Being from Singapore, we are very interested. We understand the business, and we can take this offline.
So technology, suppose we give you an offer here right now, when we give you a much lower valuation than what you want, but we give you a clawback. Would you be interested in that kind of a structure?
So are you interested in a lower valuation with a clawback based on results? I guess.
We are open to discuss that.
We are open to discussing it.
So if I give you an offer of 15 post money with a clawback.
Boss, right now, lock him. Lock him, I'm telling you.
It's a yes. It's a yes. We'll open.
You're on television.
Go for it. Go for it. I'm telling you. Okay, I'll reduce my 10% to 5%. Go for it.
You are on national television. Take it.
6 of them are interested. Congratulations.
Past 2 years, they've had very steady progressive growth. 2 employees to 14, 67 lakhs first year to 1.6 crores the past 9 months. So you can see they're building a real business.
Business model is not completely an IT play. A lot of it is going to be about sourcing the properties, going to the owners of the property, tying up with them. So that's going to decrease their size, their scale of operation. They can't grow at a very fast pace because not all software driven.
Though there are concerns with respect to, you know, scalability and defensibility, how will you lock in the demand? But there are ways that can be tackled, and there are no global players, and it will be better if an Indian outfit can be used well for India.
So before starting this venture, I was living in the US, UK and Southeast Asia for more than a decade. I have seen firsthand the impact of crowdfunding platforms in the West. And I realized when I was a student at Harvard that such platforms did not exist in India. So after working on a business plan during my entrepreneurship classwork, I decided to come back to India to actually start this venture. So let me share with you the success story of Pooja Bhatnagar. Pooja was a teacher in Delhi, and after struggling with a liver cirrhosis condition for almost 17 years, she needed a liver transplant. Her husband Anurag and her, they were short of about 25 lakh rupees in funding. So what did they do? They came to Impact Guru to start crowdfunding. Now, how did we help them? First of all, we provided them a platform to create a fundraising page on our website. Secondly, we assigned a dedicated relationship manager who would not only train them on how to raise funds beyond their immediate friends and family network, but also how to attract influencers to start promoting it. Pooja was able to mobilize 25 lakh rupees from 407 donors across 32 countries in just 2 weeks' time. So our business model is very, very lean. For every 1 lakh rupees raised, we are charging about a 5% fee. So we're looking to raise 9 crores to take us to EBITDA and cash flow break-even in the next 2 years. And it will be to ramp our customer acquisition.
With that, your time gets over, Piyush. Here you can't tinker with valuation.
Piyush, if you could manage 8 crore, why not 9? Why this 1 crore you are coming to us and...
Yes.
I mean, I can't understand. They could write 9.
RB Investments wants an external investor to be leading the round, and Venture Catalyst has a limit of 3 crores per deal. I'm looking for people who can mentor and take my company to the next level.
Well, you're taking on people who are bigger than you, even in India, but even internationally, they are very big players. So what's your strategy to kind of break through that market?
Firstly, we've already spoken to some of these people, some of these international crowdfunding platforms, and what we understood is that they do want to enter India, but only after a few years. And they're not just looking at India market, they're looking at the entire Southeast Asia market. And for that, they need a management team that's well equipped to handle not just India, but also Southeast Asia. And Piyush and I, we've lived in some of these countries in the past, we understand these markets.
How do you verify that the people who are raising the money, who need it, they really have a problem?
Firstly, when somebody puts up a story on our platform to start raising funds, they're required to upload certain documents such as hospital reports, hospital bills, diagnosis reports, things like that. As a second layer of checks and balances, we also check with the hospital about the authenticity of the case of the patient.
How do investors like us exit? Right. What's the exit for the investors?
Right. So there are multiple ways. First of all, we will be a great candidate for an international crowdfunding platform in the next 3 to 5 years. Secondly, there are multiple players in India. There could be a lot of in-market consolidation. Third of all, we want to expand beyond India into Southeast Asian markets. And so in a Series B or C growth stage round, there could be a secondary exit.
I'm interested. I just want to understand the competitive landscape a little more and the usage of funds.
Sure.
Absolutely.
Okay.
I'm interested, definitely.
Definitely interested. Okay.
Yeah, I'm definitely interested.
I am interested.
Interested?
I think being a small investor does not make sense in this whole game, so I will be out.
Interested.
Interested?
So looks like they've already raised 5 crores for 1 crore. So, same reason. Maybe next round will come with a larger check.
There is a potential to increase the amount that you're looking for.
Yes, we'll be open to take it to 10 crores for 25%.
So, they'll be open to take it to 10 crores, guys. It just went up by another crore.
There are two ways to look at it. One is that, you know, you're getting a very small part of the thing. The other thing is that, you know, somebody's already committed 8 crore at that valuation. They've also done their due diligence. So that also gives you a sense of comfort about the fact that, you know, these promoters have been vetted, their business model has been vetted, and there's a sense of assurance that, you know, these guys do know what they're talking about.
Thank you so much, Rado, CNBC, Young Turks, and Thai Delhi.
Hi, I'm Nitin. I'm the co-founder and CEO of ShapeCrunch. We are making custom foot insoles with 3D printing and smartphone. We are raising 3 crore at 12.5% equity dilution.
I have flat feet. And 2 years back, I went to a doctor. And doctor told me, you know, you have to get custom insole made. Then I went to a workshop where they take the complete foot impression, and that insole was completely incorrect. And finally, I got another correction made that also was incorrect. So being an engineer, being a person who has been working in 3D printing for quite a long time, I thought that I'm going to print off my own. We completely digitized the whole process. We made a computer vision and AI algorithm which just requires pictures of the foot. It requires pain areas and, you know, what is the level of the pain. It requires doctor's prescription. And finally, the shoe size and shoe photographs and all that stuff. And finally, the whole algorithm convert them into a 3D model, which is then 3D printed and shipped to the patient. We have done clinical research with All Institute of Medical Science. We have also got grant from Barak Research.
You typically charge, what, 3,500 for this?
Yeah, 3,500.
3,500. But it's if this is your product, the quality isn't that great, honestly. And what is the, we didn't see the math on your valuation numbers. I mean, what is your sales revenue profile?
Yeah.
I mean,
what we are expecting is within the next 2 years, we are expecting to generate revenue of 24 crore. And these all are...
What have we done so far?
So right now it's 30 lakhs.
So, you know, with time, hospitals will use 3D in-house for many requirements.
Yeah, exactly.
So if every hospital has their own in-house workshop and printer, why would they come to a third party like you?
We have taken one example, and the same technology can be used in all these cases. So ultimately, we are going to become a platform where anyone can use our service to create any kind of product.
When you're talking about a doctor's prescription, what percentage of your cases would not require a doctor and just the app?
Yeah, so basically, around 50% of the cases, you know, completely don't require kind of prescription, because these are very minor cases of flat feet where algorithm can automatically detect and correct it as well.
How much time does that take and how do you kind of do away with it?
Yeah, the manual process, as of now, from getting the images, it takes 5 minutes to after that it goes for manufacturing.
And is there a patent that you filed?
Yeah, so we have filed two patents. Two patents have been filed.
Are you looking at doing this only through doctors, or do you plan to go direct to consumer at some point?
We start with doctors, and eventually this can go for runners, this can go for comfort, this can go for any other category.
So guys, 3 crores, 2.5, actually 50 lakhs already raised for 12.5% of ShapeCrunch.
So 3 crore money is fine for 30%.
Okay.
I'll go with that.
3 crores for 30%. Two.
I would go slightly lower than that, but...
Oh, you'll even go lower than 30%?
Interested, but expensive.
Interested, but expensive at what Sanjay offered?
At what Sanjay offered, yes.
Beat him up, man.
Interested, definitely interested.
Interested, but I have a slightly different perspective on valuation here. I think they will need to raise a next round, which will be a larger round. And I think given the fact that if they're 3 crores, 30%, if they share with the angels, I think the next round might be a little bit challenging.
So you're saying that even if that is the valuation, moderate the amount of raise so
yes,
that you don't
exactly,
have to
correct.
Debut.
We all are interested. We need to see and work your capital stack out, because I don't think you've seen your runway from jumping from 30 lakhs to 24 crores in sales in 2 years. Is never going to happen. Just get realistic as to your fixed costs. We need to spend some time with you. We all are interested.
Our next plan is that if we can raise it over a convertible, where you know you discount the valuation based on the next round, and that becomes a most visible metric for us, because as of now we are in the process of scaling up, and nobody knows that what will be the revenue number after 1 year or 2 years. So that depends on our hard work. So that is what we are betting on.
The seed round. It is better to raise as low as amount and at a decent valuation, because otherwise next round will become very difficult.